In this sketchbook Saturday, I'll share my 2020 art and art business goals while painting a watercolor fox and his Luna moth friends. After sharing my goals, I'll share how I created an action plan to achieve my goals. If you don't know who I am, my name is Allison and I'm an artist. I paint nature-inspired art and work primarily with watercolor and oil paints. I've had this idea of a fox with a moth on his nose for a long time and finally sketched him in my sketchbook. I think I'll make this into a finished piece in either oil or watercolor in 2020. So I guess this could be one of my goals for 2020. First, I'm going to share my art goals and then I'll share my art business goals. The second half of 2019, I didn't paint as much as I would have liked. So this year, I want to be more intentional with making time to paint. My first goal is to paint for at least 10 hours a week. So in my calendar, I blocked out time in the mornings to paint since I have the most energy and am most productive in the mornings. I find that I paint quicker and better when I have energy to do so. My afternoons will be for computer work, like editing videos and courses, marketing, adding things to my shop, designing products, etc. In 2020, I want to try out new products like notebooks, sticker sheets, washi tape, posters, small prints, calendars, and notepads. That probably seems like a lot, and it is, but the main products that I want to be sure to try are sticker sheets, small prints, and washi tape. I'll be happy if I at least try those products. My last art goal is to complete some kind of 30-day challenge. I'd like to make my own challenge and paint a specific subject for 30 days, like butterflies, mushrooms, beetles, or whatever I feel inspired to paint for all those days. I hope to do the challenge the first half of the year. Now I'm going to share my art business goals. I have a good feeling that 2020 will be a huge year for my art business. This will be my third full year in business, and I feel like I'm finally going to get some traction and all my hard work these last few years will pay off. At least that's what I hope. There are two main things I'll be focusing on this year in my business: wholesale and watercolor courses. My hope is that these two will be the main income streams for my business, and art and product sales and other income streams will be the cherries on top. Each month, I'll research and contact 20 stores that I think will be a good fit for my art products. And by the end of the year, to have contacted at least 240 stores. I plan to have my stickers and prints available for wholesale. As for watercolor courses, my plan is to create and launch 4 watercolor courses. The first one will be a watercolor beginner course. The other 3 will be painting a specific subject. I'm thinking my second course will be a watercolor butterfly course. In 2019, I found myself doing many things that I didn't quite enjoy or that I could delegate to someone else. While I'm not currently financially able to hire someone, I hope that in 2020, I'll be able to, at least part-time or someone on Upwork. I know that hiring help will help my business grow so that I can have more time to create art, which in turn means more art and products I can sell. It would be great to find someone to edit YouTube tutorials, add listings to my shop, help me contact those stores for wholesale, design new products, and package orders. So my goal is to at least be able to have someone help me in some way for a few hours a week in 2020 with any of those tasks. Now I'll share some of my social media goals for my business. For YouTube, I plan to upload at least 6 videos a month. I want to make weekly studio vlogs, as well as tutorials, art product videos, and artist tips. For Instagram, my goal is to upload primarily videos, kind of like what I do now. I found that my followers prefer painting videos instead of photos. I also get a lot more traction and reach with videos. My goal is to upload to Instagram 3 to 5 days a week and to stories at least once a day. I also want to be 100% authentic and try to give as much value as possible to my followers. For TikTok, I hope to upload consistent content. I don't know much about TikTok, so I hope to also learn more about it and how to leverage it as an artist. I'm on TikTok now, but I haven't really uploaded for a few months. And for Facebook, I plan to still post to my group a few times a week, but I won't be focusing much on Facebook for 2020. Instagram and YouTube will be my main focus for social media. Now I'm going to share my number goals with you. To be honest, I don't believe the amount of followers or subscribers determine how successful we are, so I don't put too much importance on these number goals. For YouTube, my goal is to surpass 5,000 subscribers, but I kind of feel like this goal might be too optimistic though, so we'll see. For my email list, I hope to have 1,000 email subscribers by the end of 2020. I currently have just over 200 subscribers. And for Instagram, I actually don't have a follower goal, but it would be nice to get at least 5,000 followers by the end of 2020. Now that I've shared my 2020 goals with you, I want to share how I created an action plan to achieve my goals. First, I journaled the things that I'd like to accomplish in 2020 and beyond. Then I created a list of the goals for this year. I tried to be as realistic as possible, but also make them challenging enough. Then I narrowed my goal list down. It's best to have a few strong goals than a bunch of goals. Having too many goals is counterproductive and overwhelming. There is a saying I really like, and it's this: if everything is important, nothing is important. Then I wrote out all of the months with space for each to write the things I need to do to accomplish my goals. So each month I have a list of action steps I need to complete in order to accomplish my goals by the end of the year. This is vital because if you have goals but don't write out the steps to achieve them, then your chances of achieving your goals are slim. This is also nice to do because I already know what I need to do for the next 12 months. It's all written out, and now I just need to check them off my list. I would love to know your goals for 2020. Comment below and share them with us. And if you'd like to watch more art videos like this, I linked the previous Sketchbook Saturdays in the description below. I hope you enjoyed this video, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you can watch more art-related videos like this one. I hope you'll have an amazing 2020. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.